Hello, everyone. After our last episode, I spent some time over here in the medieval village. I'm just gonna give you a quick look around. We're not gonna go into wrong F button, a whole lot of details. I got most of the castle put together over here. As you can see, I've added quite a four more buildings and some walkways, a guard tower. And I've really been working on the walls, and it's gotten kind of dull and boring. And there's some other things that I'd rather do right now. I just need to take a break because I'm kind of at a loss as to what to do. I wonder where my game sounds are. Hold on just a second. Okay, that's better. Okay. So, since the last episode, like I said, I've been working on medieval town over here. And let me pick up all the dirt. And I've gotten kind of stumped as to where I want to go and exactly do next. So we're going to go work on another project. I'll show you some other stuff. I did a blacksmith's little house and shop here. You can actually throw the ores into the fire and they'll come out over here on this side. None of the insides have, I don't have interiors yet, but I've got it kind of laid out. I've started working on some of the buildings so you can kind of see the style that I'm kind of working with here. And then you've seen the walls and stuff. So let's go into the nether. And while I'm in the nether, I'll tell you what we're going to be working on today. We're going to go work on what I'm going to call the industrial complex, which is going to be the area where I'm going to set up an iron farm, a witch farm, slime farm, that kind of stuff, all over there. As you can see, I've been working on the nether hub. I think this is kind of a good design for the main area, and that clicking is my furnace over here. I've got a nether furnace going to keep making nether brick for us from all the digging out that I've done. I've got all the tunnels to the new areas that we found in the last episode or two. I've got those tunnels done. And then I'm working on a rail system in here. And I've kind of got it laid out. I'm not going to tell you exactly too much more about that right now. No, we don't need to go to the main base. What we're going to do is go to the industrial complex, which is back this way. It's out in the swamp biome where we found the witch hut. And since our last episode, I've been gathering some stuff up. As you can see, I've got villagers ready for the iron farm. Although I've since discovered that I'm about 4 short, so once we get it set up, they'll have to breed first before we get any iron out of it. But they're sitting here in the nether because they're safe here. The zombie pigmen don't bother them. They don't really care about that, and so I don't have to worry about making sure the zombies don't kill them until I can get them put into the iron farm. And this is going to be our industrial complex. I've got small wheat farm just kind of going over there for food, and I've got the nether portal set up to bring in the villagers once we get done. I'll have to lay some track down. That big square over there is where our iron farm is going to be, and I'm gonna build it on camera, but it's going to be built differently than normal. I've got something new I'm trying out. It's a mod called a replay mod that lets you record your gameplay and then do kind of neat little replays. So as long as I can get it to work and figure out how to do a good third person, it'll be a third person time lapse of me kind of building this thing. But up here is going to be the base of the iron farm. I gotta do some checking, make sure I got the measurements right before I get started. Off in the distance, you should be able to see some more acacia wood columns. That's actually supposed to be a triple slime chunk sitting over there. It's kind of in an L shape. I've not done anything other than kind of mark it out. I'm gonna go down and at some point and kind of check to see if slime are actually spawning down there in all three chunks. This dirt column right here marks an underground cave system that I still need to light up and stuff for to keep the spawn down for the witch farm that we're eventually going to build over there, and a mob farm that I'm going to build out here somewhere. Just a general mob farm to get bones and zombie flesh and gunpowder and stuff. So, hopefully we'll be back in just a minute or so with a really awesome third person time lapse of me building the iron farm. I think what I'll do is I'll build it and then I'll come back. We'll talk about it while I'm trying to get the villagers in there, and then we'll should be set up. The iron farm that I'm using is kind of a standard iron farm. It's gonna have should have four villagers on each side with I believe like 48 doors, and they'll all come down to the middle, drop down. I'll have them drop down into a hole and get burnt by lava, and then I'm gonna have it so that I can turn it off, which will basically just be probably I might turn it make it so that I turn the lava off and block the hole up so none of them fall down. And so that's my plans. We'll see what happens in just a bit. Bye-bye. Hi guys, I'm back. I hope you enjoyed that little time lapse there of me building the main part of the iron farm. I've got one more time lapse for you today, because today is an episode of time lapses. Yay, now that I can do them. Woohoo! It's going to be to put the holding cells on and setting up the rail lines for putting the villagers in there, so that we can actually get this thing rocking and rolling, because we really need some iron, because I want to do some rail lines and train stations and stuff like that. So enjoy this next one. We'll hopefully play some interesting music with it when I get done editing, and when we get back, I will go into the nether, grab the villagers, and try and get them in their holding cells. So see you later. Everybody, hope you enjoyed that time lapse too. Now let's go take these rails that I've got here in my hand and go see if we can get these villagers over here. So as you can see, and as you saw in the last one, we've got some temporary rail lines set up all the way around. I'll do a quick explanation. The switches that are out here are basically just to make the track switch over. What we'll do is we'll run them here, and then when we get ready to go, we'll run them to the far side. We get ready to go to the next one. All I got to do is flip that switch, and they'll jump that little cross and then go into there. So, or at least that's the plan. Let me make a quick different pickaxe. That's not my diamond pickaxe, so that I don't hurt them too badly if I accidentally hit them getting them out of the minecarts. Where's something? I guess a wood one will work. 1, 2, 3, and a couple of sticks. This way, when I go to break the minecart, if I accidentally hit them, it won't be hard enough to actually do a whole lot of damage, because I didn't think about bringing healing potions. But they will come through and get caught in that minecart right there, and then we'll roll them under here and out. And it's daylight so far, so we're doing good. Matter of fact, I don't want to do that because I don't want to lose the minecart. In case the minecart gets bumped, and then we'll just roll one at a time. So, let's see how we can do this, because we got 12 of them to get over here. And as everybody knows, working with villagers is so much fun. Because they don't always want to do what you want them to do. Alright, let's get this guy rolling. Go, 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 go down the train line. Go, go, go. Alright, now, hopefully, when I get this out from under him, he will go through the portal. There he goes. Alright, now. Push him onto this side and get him in the minecart just like that. Take out that block. Oh, I'm sorry about the portal. It is very loud. And now he should go on a nice little trip and end up all the way to the far side. Let's see if we can get over there without falling off. And he should just drop right down into the holding cell that we built and be okay. Let's see if that worked out. Yes, it did. All right, so all I got to do is come here, and I've got the ladder set up so that he can't get back up the ladder. And there's my phone going off, so give me just a moment. Okay, we're back. There's nothing important. Anyway, as I was saying, the ladder is one off the ground so that I can get up the ladder, but he can't. If we start having problems, what I can do is keep them in the middle of the holding cell, is I can put water in the four corners. But I think since I've got them blocked off, they're lit up really well, and it's high up in the air, we shouldn't have any problems with critters and zombies trying to get to them. The zombies are still going to track them, but they're not going to be able to reach them. Alright, let's take out the rail. Alright, let's go get another one. We're going to do 3 in each cell because I've got 12. But I think I need 16 in order to actually get it to work. Alright, yes, taking your buddy. So once we get them in, go, go, go. Once we get all of them spread out, they should start to breed because there's enough doors. There are 48 doors, if I remember correctly. Alright, he should go through, except he's being stubborn. There we go. Alright. Hey! This is why working with villagers. There we go. Go on, stubborn. Do you too. Go. I'll see you in a minute. Oh, that was close. Alright. I must have got the mine cart. He's going to need a little extra push. But anyway, so I'm setting up this iron farm because I want to... Oh, really? Because I want to use... I need iron for rails. And some hoppers and stuff for some other stuff that I'm working on. And even though I don't mind going out and mining, having an iron farm is going to make it a lot faster. Because I'd like to be able to hook up my villages in the nether with rail. And also hook up my towns and stuff with rail in the overworld. And I know that's kind of overkill as far as transportation systems are concerned, but I like, you know, the railroads and stuff like that, and I like dealing with the minecart stations and stuff, so that's something we're going to be working on in the future. Now, don't be as stubborn as your buddy was. What I may do, since this is pretty much the same process all the way through, is... Okay, he went through. Is that I may cut right here after I get this guy in. And yeah, he's going to be just as stubborn as his buddy was. Is I may just cut... Hey, dude. Well, if you want to walk there, that's fine, but I was going to push you. Is I may cut right in here somewhere after I get this guy in here. And, alright, those guys should be safe. Let's check the sun. Right now, all I gotta do is flip that switch, and the next set of guys will run into this one. I mean, I know I could have just cut the rail out from under them, but I figured that would be a little bit faster to do it that way. And it just, you know, adds a little bit of fun to the whole process, as if working with the villagers wasn't fun enough. So let's get this guy going. We'll go ahead and turn that power rail on. That'll make him cruise a little quicker down here to the portal. Oh, he went completely through the portal. I wish they would go through the portal in the minecart so that they would already be stuck in the minecart when they got to the other side. Yeah, good thing I was using a wood pickaxe there. I think I smacked him. And of course, alright, while he's rolling, I'm gonna come sleep. Yeah, anyway, I wish they would go through the portal in a minecart, because that would make moving, you know, villagers or even cows or pigs or stuff a lot easier if they would just go through in the minecart. Alright, now let's see if he ended up where he was supposed to. Yes, he did. Alright, let's carefully get that out. There we go. Eat some food. And I'm going to leave those ladders in there for right now. Once I get everybody in, then, you know, all this rail that I've got set up here, along with the ladders, will be taken out. I'll put the rest of the roofs on, and then we'll be good to go. And hope this, once I'm sure they're breeding. Uh-huh. And then we'll be getting some iron. The one thing I did not show you that I may show you in just a little bit is I've got it set up so that I can turn it on and off. Basically, it turns the lava flow off and plugs up the hole in the bottom. Come on, dude. Really? This is why I decided to record this, because I figured y'all would enjoy watching me fumble around with these guys, because they're being very stubborn and not playing well with others today. There we go. Ooh, about ran off the side. Let me go do a quick check on these guys over here, make sure they're a-okay. Yep, everybody's fine and happy hunky dory over here. And then the particles that you see, there's torches inside. Inside where the iron farm's at, so that nothing spawns in there. Alrighty. Alright, I think what I'm going to do is let y'all watch this one more. Watch me fumble with one more, and then I will take care of the other six, because it's just the same process, back and forth through the portal, bringing one at a time. And I will probably keep recording, and that way if something interesting happens, I'll have it recorded. Otherwise, we'll just pick back up in just a bit. So let's get this guy through. There we go. Hopefully, I'll come out on this side and won't push him out. Where did this guy go? Oh no. Where did he go? Why is he way over there? No! Just can't get good help nowadays. Hey, back here. Where are you going? Stop! To you too. Now I gotta get him all the way back over there. So, guess that's what we'll be doing here. We'll build a on your buddy's head. Move. Yes, guys, make love, not aggravation. Come on, make more hearts. You know you want to. Alright, I'm going to cut right here, and I will keep recording, and if something interesting happens again, then we'll be back. Otherwise, we'll show you that I'll have all of them set up and make sure that they're breeding good, and then hopefully we'll be getting some iron soon. So have a nice day, and hopefully I will too. Okay, I don't know if y'all can hear this. Now how did a skeleton spawn in here? Well, we've already got iron golems. Huh. Interesting. So let's come down here and see. All right. Iron. Huh. It works. Down through the nether, hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether. I'm hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether. Oh yeah, hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether. Hopping through the nether, oh yeah, doo doo doo. Hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether, hopping through the nether, yeah, doo doo doo. Alrighty, welcome back. As you can see, this is the last villager that we're bringing in here. You should be pretty well lit up. So there's three there. There is three here with a baby. And then there's three here with a baby. Good. Now let's see if these three have made a baby yet. Three here and no baby. Y'all are behind, aren't you? Let's see if I've got anything to make these guys willing to trade. I don't have anything that these guys want. Nothing. Unless I can go, I may have enough bread to get these guys started. And then we'll check on the other group over there. So we will see if they like that. If not, I will have to go back to my base and get some more bread and other stuff. So let's see if we can at least get some hearts going here. Because really all we need is, I think, four villagers in each one of these holding cells. And then we should have enough villagers to start spawning more iron golems. I do have the system turned on, so if we do have iron golems, we should be getting iron. Alright, these guys have made a baby now. And these have a baby. Alright, good. Now, let's come down here. We'll get some slabs. There they are. And I can go ahead and cover up the roof so they're nice and safe, the ones that have the babies already. I may come back later and put trap doors in just so that I can keep an eye on them and check on them if need be. Alright, they had a baby. Please have a baby. Cross the other side. These have a baby. And, ooh, I made it. These over here are trying really hard. So I may have to get some more bread for these guys. Or go see if I've got some bone meal. Let's quickly jump down to the bottom here. And we'll come down here. And yes, we are getting iron and poppies. Now this one chest is probably not going to be enough to hold the iron. Alright, so anyway, this is the system for turning it off. I've got a button here. It sends a pulse to these dispensers right here, which dispense the lava. And then I've just got a T flip-flop right here that turns the pistons on or off that closes up the hole. So if I don't want any more iron or whatever and I want to turn it off, it will just keep them from dropping down. And since they're dropping down, not dropping down, they're staying up there, then they will, not spawn anymore. So I think that's it. Let me go sleep real quick and then I will sign off of here. Yay, let me sleep. As you can see, I had problems earlier with being able to sleep. Alright then, there we go. Thank you for coming along and being patient with my time lapses. I know there were a lot in this episode. I was trying out, like I said, the replay mod and trying to figure out how they work. And so I wanted to do a couple to make sure that I had a grasp over it. I think I'm going to be using that fairly regularly, just because, especially over here with my industrial zone, it's hard to walk around like this with my industrial zone, because as you can see back here behind me, I've got a witch farm that we're gonna build. But I think the next thing on the list is gold. There's gold in the Nether Hills. It'll be a gold farm, which will simply be a big gigantoid portal where they fall off the side, where the zombie pigmen fall off the side into some water and get crushed to death. So that will probably be our next project. Ooh, and there's some flames, which means there's an iron golem getting burned to death. Yay! Yep, that's it. It's working! And I'll keep an eye on those villagers up top and make sure that I get 4 in each box. Whoa! We don't need to see inside my head. Okay, signing off. Bye-bye.